Welcome to r/TalesFromYourServer. It's the place where waiters share awesome stories about their guests. Thank you to all the people who subscribe to this channel. It means a lot for me. Today we have three good stories. And the first story is, fired with no severance? Okay, but don't be surprised when I come get what's mine. I worked at a casual upscale restaurant in British Columbia. I was there for a year. I mentioned BC because employees get great support from the Provincial Employment Standards Act, ESA. An employee must be written up 3 times before there can be a serious threat of termination. The write-up has to be co-signed for it to count. In December, for example, I showed up to work 30 minutes late. It was completely unlike me, and after the shift I signed a write-up, no problem. It was my only documented transgression while working there. I feel like now is the right time to tell you guys that 2019 was not kind to me. I was attacked and robbed mid-year, court case ongoing, and I've been attending 2 kinds of therapy for my PTSD, and my beloved mother passed near the end of the year from terminal cancer. Her diagnosis came about a month after I was attacked. I tell you this for context, not for sympathy. Nobody at my work even remotely knew about what I was going through. I kept everything completely compartmentalized. What I'm trying to say is, my professionalism was not affected. Anyway, with the arrival of 2020, management decided to really tighten the reins. They were cracking down on everything. With all that going on, my GM and I decided I should take January off. Mom's birthday would have been mid-January. Upon my return, I was inexplicably held to an extremely intensive standard. Turns out giving me that time off put the restaurant through a little strain. Okay, not my fault. I was told it was totally fine, and even preferable for me to take the vacation. My first Monday back was the first snow day in Vancouver, where transit was actually running. I arrived at work 4 minutes late, but was the second person in the building after the bartender. My first and second days back, I performed well enough to get decent tips, but management could tell I was stressed, so they put me on probation, a conversation for which there was no record and no co-signage. Furthermore, according to the ESA I mentioned earlier, you can't just randomly put an employee with only one write-up on probation. At the end of the meeting, my GM said, "See you Saturday," because that was my usual schedule. Monday, Tuesday, Saturday. Unfortunately, a new manager had been hired in to do scheduling and gave me shift outside my availability, which I missed. A head office manager calls me on Friday, and when he realizes I didn't know I was scheduled, again, outside my usual schedule, he says, "Don't worry about it, my friend. If your boss needs you, she'll call you in." Here's where SH goes down. GM calls. I say, I was called off by an HO manager. She hangs up on me. I figure out a ride to work and text her that I can be there in 15. She tells me no, just come in for a meeting tomorrow. Tomorrow comes. I tell her I'm having severe anxiety and wish she would call or text so I understood what I was walking into in order to help manage my anxiety. And I get this text. "Your final paycheck is in the mail. No severance." No explanation, no legal justification, and apparently no severance pay. I asked to be contacted so the terms of my firing can be properly explained to me. One of the top dogs, a man we'll call Kevin, calls me a few days later. He says, "You're an employee, not our emotional responsibility. We don't care if you sign the warning. If the GM says she spoke to you and there's no record, it still goes on your file. If we terminate another employee for missing shifts 7 times in 2 months, that has nothing to do with you, because that's our discretion. Speaking about it is actually a breach of the other person's employee confidentiality. Look, I'm sorry your mom died and you were assaulted, etc., but that's not our problem. Take a look in the mirror and take responsibility for your trauma. Our only duty to you is to pay you if you show." As you can tell, Kevin is lovely. I've filed with the government and will be demanding severance for wrongful termination. I'll keep you guys updated. The second story is, customer assaults me after eating a single sprinkle off her cake, doesn't like it, damages the cake and demands a full refund. So this is going to be a long one with a bit of backstory. Let's get into it. I manage a cake shop slash cafe. We specialize in ready-to-buy birthday cakes. We're a very small store. Pretty much from every corner you can hear what's going on out the front. We also have a camera view of the entire shop front, with a viewing screen out the back. So I saw and heard everything in the lead-up to my encounter with the customer. Just over a week ago on a Friday, a very busy day for us, a lady came into the store to buy a birthday cake for her son. Should be a very normal situation. I don't usually pay attention to what's going on front of house, because that's what the service staff are for. I was busy out the back making custom cake orders for the weekend, but my ears perked when I hear her asking for discounts on the products in the display case. Our display is always full of fresh cakes. The cake she ended up picking was only finished and ready for sale about an hour before she brought it. I had a bad feeling she was going to be a problem customer, so I was getting ready to go out to speak with her if needed, But she ended up happily getting the cake after being told the cakes were fresh, and we had no discounted cakes today by the service staff. That's the end, right? No. About 3 hours later, my coworker, I'll call him D from here on, takes a call. I didn't hear both sides, but D was explaining it to me as the conversation was going on. I was elbow deep in cheesecake, so I didn't just grab the call myself. So this lady is saying she brought a cake earlier today. After she got home, she ate a sprinkle out of the box that fell off the cake and says it's disgusting. She wants a full refund or a replacement cake because she thinks the sprinkles are stale. I tell D to ask her what it tastes like and to explain sprinkles are just condensed sugar and coloring. They don't taste great on their own, and the batch in question was delivered fresh to us just 2 days before. She asks D to promise we will replace the cake. He explains we can't promise that, but we would be happy to come up with a suitable solution for her if she could bring the cake and her receipt back into the store so we could understand what was going on. She screams at him over the phone. I couldn't understand what she was saying, but I could hear the screaming coming from the phone. She hangs up before anything else could be said. 20 minutes later, I see her enter the store with the cake box in hand. She will be called Crazy Cake B, CCB from here on. D goes out to try to help CCB. He opens the cake to see CCB has jammed her own pirate decorations and candles into the cake roughly. The top's destroyed, some of the frosting is squished onto the side of the box, and the happy birthday writing on the top is damaged. We have a pretty firm refund policy. Once a cake has left the store, it cannot be refunded for change of mind. And we're not meant to allow foreign objects into the bakery, her pirate decorations. After going through CCB's complaint again, D offers to directly fix the problem. Remove the sprinkles and replace them with a new layer of cream and chocolate flakes, or different sprinkles of her choice, free of charge for her troubles. He also offers to fix the other damage she caused, free as well. This is not good enough. CCB yells at him that it's BS and it's not good enough. The sprinkles taste like SH. I need a replacement cake or a full refund. D says he needs to talk with the manager and asks for her receipt. She doesn't have it. D brings the cake back to show me. CCB is angry, and I want to deal with this as cleanly as possible, so I call the owner and ask for advice. The owner thinks the customer is SH talking to get freebies, but agrees it would be better to have this in cleanly, tells me to give CCB a half refund, and offer to still fix the cake and give it back. I take the cake back out to her and explain what I can do. I make sure I'm as kind and apologetic as possible. At this point, she's been in the store for 7 minutes total. The store is also full of other customers. She still complains it's not good enough, and asks why I can't just give her a full refund and a brand new cake. I say, I'm very sorry, it has left the store and has objects put into it, so we can't take it back. The sprinkles are fresh, and there doesn't appear to be anything wrong with it. I'm sorry you don't like it, we're more than happy to replace them and refund half the money for the trouble. The cake is on a little bench between us. Our conversation has lasted 22 seconds. I see a look come over her face, and she says under her breath, "You know what?" and she grabs for the cake. I think, oh, she's gonna storm out. Nope, CCB opens the box, lifts it open, and brings the cake down on me at full force. Just some perspective, I'm a 5'6 medium build mid-20s female. CCB is at least 6'1 and rather large. I'm lucky that I'm quick enough to get my hands up to stop the cake, so it doesn't come down on my head, but of course it's a light sponge cake with cream, so it breaks up and showers all over me in the shop floor. CCB immediately legs it out of the store. D comes out from the back, having seen it from the security camera screen, and follows her to the parking lot, and takes a picture of her in her car. D says she tried to run him over getting out. Another customer also follows her and gets her license plate as well. I'm still standing there covered in cake, in front of a shop full of customers. I excuse myself out the back, take off the cake-covered apron and hat, wash it off my arms and face, then go out to apologize to the other customers in the store, and start cleaning the floor. The panic starts to settle in me, and I start feeling a strained pain in my right arm, where I took most of the force of the cake box hit. My brain's still pretty foggy, so I don't think to call the police or security. This is an insane story as it is, but it just gets worse. Not even half an hour later, I'm still cleaning cake from everywhere, by the way. D takes a phone call from our regional manager. I'll call him RM. It's a franchise. We're singularly owned but governed by a head office. RM is furious and demands we will be giving CCB's husband a full refund, saying it's now company policy that we give out refunds no matter what. D asks if he's heard the full story. RM says, "No, I don't care. Give the D refund. Husband will be in to pick it up in 20 minutes. Then hangs up. When D tells me, I immediately try to call back. No answer, so I call my store owner. Owner is peeved RM stepped in to do that, but tells us to comply for the moment, because if she was violent before, we don't want to aggravate the husband. I have no clue how they contacted RM so quickly. The only people with access to his number are employees. My best guess is she went to a store in the franchise and lied her way to getting them to call him. Pretty much on the dot, the husband comes into the store. He's quiet and takes the money from D. We get him to sign a form saying he's taken the money. Just as he's about to leave, he shouts back, "So this means you'll delete the picture?" D says no. Husband repeats, "You'll be deleting the photos." I walk out the front, stupidly I now realize, and say, "I won't, they're going straight to the police." Husband looks me dead in the eye, points at me and says, "If you do, I'll be back, and it won't be cake you'll be cleaning off the floor." I shout back as he's leaving, now I can add threats to my police report. Stupid courage is apparently a symptom I get when scared. I finished up everything I needed to and updated the owner, and asked for her to download and send me the CCTV, and I headed to the police station to make a report. No way am I letting them get away with treating people like this. I made that initial report that day and was going to come back with the CCTV the next day. But oh, it gets crazier. I get a message through our store Facebook from someone who knows CCB, including screenshots from the CCB's Facebook of her bragging about the entire incident. She goes as far as admitting to the assault and admitting to getting her husband to threaten physical harm if we went to the police. So I took all of that to the police too, as well as going to the doctor to get my arm checked. He recorded elbow and tricep sprains, damage and swelling. Also got him to make a note of emotional stress and anxiety from the threats. The investigator thinks it will go to court for assault, but I'm still waiting to hear any more from them. I've barely slept this week, my arm's getting better quickly, so that's good at least. I'm so paranoid every day at work that they'll come back or find where I live, but I couldn't stay quiet and let them get away with it. I'll update if anything new happens. It's been really nice to get this off my chest and write it down. I would love to post the footage with this, but I'm worried it could affect the case. Quick update, I went back to the doctors. I have soft tissue damage in my right arm, from my elbow to my shoulder, from where I put my arms up to defend myself. I've also been put on light anti-anxiety medication and sleeping pills to try and get some rest. I've also been in contact with the police. Apparently CCB and husband have been dodging calls and not answering the phone. They say CCTV and the social media posts isn't enough for them to be charged, without the opportunity to give their side of the story. But if they don't answer soon, a warrant will be put out for them and their car. And the last story is, I quit. I got a job serving at a senior living community a few months ago. It's been absolute heck since day one. The kitchen manager is a grumpy F who purposefully gets residents' orders wrong and will scream, cuss, and throw things when you ask for the correct item. Higher-ups can't get on the same page. One person will tell me to do things a certain way, then a different person will come around and scream at me for doing it that way. Employees treat each other like absolute SH. One employee went around saying the N-word to people and is still employed and never reprimanded at all. This week I found out my hours had been cut out of nowhere, despite us being short-handed and more residents moving in every week. I saw my schedule was changed, and I won't even make enough to pay for childcare, so F it, I'm not going back. I've never quit a job without giving notice in my entire life, and I feel so anxious about it, but the toxicity is killing me. Thank you for listening, have a nice day.